Praise the Lord. And so this morning, many of our brethren, by the grace of God, they have been speaking to us so many topics. And we have been taking our text from the book of John chapter 2, John chapter 5, verse 2 to 9. And I still want us to revisit that place once again. When we look at that scripture, we discover that that man that was an impotent, he was there for 38 good years. And that day Jesus visited him was the day that the impotent is over. And today, I want to decree this time that as many of us have been here for a long time problem, by the special grace of God, it is over in Jesus' name. And I want to look at the life of that man. Not only that, that man that was impotent, he could not recognize Jesus. When Jesus was moving, and he told him, "Can you be made whole?" What did he say? He said, "I have no man." Why? He was blinded. He could not see that the Prince of Peace is talking. The owner of the world is talking. The man who can say, "No man reverse it," is talking. He could not understand because of the pain, because of what he see, because of what he's passing through. He could not understand. He was answering him. He said, "I have no man." Which person did he look for? The Bible said, "If your father, your mother forsake you, and I will lift you up." And he's speaking, and the man is saying, "I have no man." And I pray today that every problem that will block our life, when Jesus is speaking by our side, he's tapping you. He says, "Son, don't worry, it is over." You are trying to say, "I don't understand, I don't recognize." I pray today that situation will all from our life in Jesus' name. And now we also see that man was in the place of his healing. Praise the Lord. That place of Bethsaida was the right place for the man to be there. Because that was the place where healing had been taking place. If you look at the scripture, you discover that the scripture said the man, the impotent, the blind, everybody were there. For what? In order for them to do what? To get healing. That was, the man was in the right place. But yet, he could not get the healing. Despite he was in the right place. Because of what? Because he has nobody to push him, to tell him, to direct him, to hold him, to say, "Yes, the time has come. Enter." He has nobody. Until Jesus Christ came down. That means in our situation that we are passing through, no man can help us, no human being, but it is only the Lord Jesus who can help. I pray that Jesus Christ will be with us in our situation, and he will deliver us in Jesus' name. And the next one is number 4. You discovered, despite of the wrong answer, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Despite of the wrong answer that the man gave Jesus, when Jesus was asking, he said, "I have no man." He was starting to do what? He was complaining. And he was saying, "Before I move, another person enter. Before I do this." But because that day was the day that he has made, right from the time he was there, that is the day that he was set free. That was the day the Lord will lift him up. That was the day the Lord will take him out from the dungeon of impotence. That was the rightful day, a remarkable day in his life that we'll never forget. Despite of that, God, Jesus Christ, he went. After he finished, he said what? He said, "Take up thy bed and go." And I pray today that everything in our life, that are standing as a wrong, that are making us not to recognize, by the special grace of God, the Almighty God of heaven will remove it in our life in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. In number five, you discover that the challenge of 30 years in a single day, a single hour, a single minute, it becomes a testimony. Praise the Lord. He became a testimony. After 38 years, the Bible said, the children of Israel, they were in the land of Egypt for 430 years. The same that day, the Lord delivered them and set them free. I pray, every long time problem that is standing between us and God, that he said, I cannot give way, that he's speaking like King Nebuchadnezzar, and he's saying, who is that man that shall deliver you from my hand? I say today, by the special grace of God, every challenge in our life, tomorrow today, they will turn to testimony in our life in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. And by the grace of God, this hour, I want to talk on the subtitle that says, be thankful for challenges that comes your way. Praise the Lord. Be thankful for the challenges that come your way. Praise the Lord. Now, when you look at the book of James chapter 1, verse 2 to 4. James chapter 1, verse 2 to 4. James chapter 1, verse 2 to 4.
James chapter 1, from verse 2. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, when you look at challenges, challenges is meant for everybody. Praise the Lord. No man on earth that is too big that he cannot face challenge. No man of God that liveth on the surface of the earth that will not face challenge. Jesus faced challenge. And so, as he faced the challenge, he did not allow the challenges to swallow him. He didn't allow the challenges to overcome him. And so, when you look at people today, there are a lot of challenges in different ways, in different places, in different circumstances as we go along. As for your child of God, you are moving from one place to the other. There are obstacles, there are challenges, there are troubles, there are problems, there are everything the enemy is planning, is setting up. He said, yes, you're moving out this morning. This is what you are going to face. But then, what do? You need to understand that the time of challenge you are facing, the Bible says, count it joy. Let there be joy. Let there be happiness. It should not be a time of murmur. It should not be a time you open your mouth so wide and begin to complain. You meet brother A, you meet brother C, you meet brother E, you meet brother F, and you say, have you seen what I'm passing through today? Have you seen what I'm going on today? You don't know. Times you made a mistake. You meet the person who is in charge of what you're passing through. What do you see? He will go back to his chamber. He will say, yes, what I am doing towards this individual is what is working. You don't need to do that. That time is not a time of complaining. Are you being persecuted? Wherever you are living, people are being cursed you. People are being sending people, mocking at you, talking anyhow. As far as God is concerned, in the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 30, in the book of Matthew, if we look at the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 30, the Bible says, fear not, for the whole hair of your hair are all numbered. None will fall without the knowledge of God. That means, no matter what the challenge you face, God is by your side. He only don't be looking at you. What is the outcome? What are you doing? And that means in this life, any challenge, anything you find yourself, any part of this, no obstacle, there is no issue, there is no trouble, that way does not lead to anything good. Without challenge, you can't sit up. Without challenge, you can't make it. Challenge is what? It's a stepping stone to your breakthrough. It's a stepping stone to your miracle. Challenge is a stepping stone. Are you walking around? You want to enter a vehicle. The man will say, why do you want to enter this room? Can your father buy a car? It's a challenge. Look at that man very well. By next time he saw you, God of heaven will do what? Will give you a car. It's a challenge. You use that challenge to do what? To draw the hand of God down so that the Almighty God will be able to help us in Jesus' name. Now, when you look at the world, in the way we read, the Bible made us understand that these challenges we are talking about, challenges, it is very, very important that we cannot do without challenges. We look at adversity. Adversity is the mother of invention. Why man adversity always is God's opportunity to step you to where God wants you to be. Adversity is a mother of invention. It makes you to understand that adversity, when it's pregnant, it will bring out something that will make people to gather. Crowd will gather. If you are fighting when you are challenged, if you are fighting when you have problems, if you are fighting when you are in time of temptation or trial, when you are fighting, what happened? You are trying to tell the people that I am not ready yet. So we should be able to understand that we should be, when we are challenged come to us, we should do what? We should be able to do what? To maintain, to endure it, and to do what? To endure to the end. We see God opportunity. He said, difficult give back to opportunity. And we look at it, that every difficult thing you face today, it gives birth to opportunity in your life. Challenges of life is a way when God has programmed for me and you. It's just like a water that is running out. And when the water is running out, what happens? You don't need to be under the water while it's running. No, you need to be on top. If you are running under the water in the river, what happens? It will swallow you. When challenges come, you don't allow that challenge to swallow you. No. You have to face the challenge. You have to tell God, this is a challenge I'm facing. And the Almighty God of heaven will set you free in Jesus' name. Let's, our brother, read the book of Proverbs chapter 24 in verse 10. Proverbs 24 verse 10.
Proverbs 24 verse 10. If you faint in the day of adversity, your strength is small.
Praise the Lord. The scripture is telling us this morning that the challenges you are passing through, because challenges you are passing through today, he said, if you fail in the days of adversity, what happened? Your strength is just small. Nobody can say trouble will not come. Trouble must surely. It is a must that it must come to you. You cannot say, I don't need any trouble. You can't. You will not. As far as you're a child of God, challenges must come. It can be challenge of anger, challenge of nakedness, challenge of no food, any kind of challenge you are facing. You need to do what? You need to endure it and believe God, that God of heaven will not forsake us in Jesus' name. And now when you look at the book of Isaiah chapter 49 in verse 15. The Bible said, can a mother forget his second child without having compassion on him? But yet I will not forsake you. As a child of God, in your challenges, in your situation, God is there with you. And I pray that the Almighty God of heaven will help us in Jesus' name. Now, when challenges come, what do we do? What do we do? When you are facing challenges, what are the things we need to do? Number one things we don't know to do. What you should not do when challenges come. One, don't run away from your church. The church you are, we are in gate of heaven. If challenges come, don't run away from your church. What do you do? Don't complain and don't murmur. Let the man of God know what you are passing through. And the Almighty God will help us in Jesus' name. Be prayerful. Study your Bible. thank God for making it possible for you to pass through that challenge. Then, number six, avoid unfriendly friend. The friend that you always go, he always discourage you. He say every day, church, 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 why are you doing that? Please avoid that kind of friend. Number seven, be a friend of God. Seek his faith by fasting and by prayer. Talk to him. Be closer to God, and the Almighty God of heaven will set you free in Jesus' name. Example of those who pass through challenges in the scripture. Look at Jesus. Look at Jesus Christ. Look at the three evil children. And look at Daniel, Paul, and Silas. And look at the woman of issue of blood. He passed through challenges. For 12 good years, he was there. But in that challenge, what did he do? He said one thing. If I can only touch the hem of Jesus, I will do what? I will be made whole. And I pray that the Almighty God of heaven will help us out in Jesus' name. Shall we all rise up in our feet, please? Praise the Lord. Now I want us to pray some prayer point this time. I want you to pray. He said, oh God, my Father, every arrow of spiritual weakness assigned against my life, backfire this morning in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Every spiritual weakness. Spiritual weakness. When you are facing trouble, you cannot pray. You don't know what to do. You are confused because of the spiritual weakness that you are passing through. Open your mouth and pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, every spiritual sleep and slumber assigned over my life, disappear from me now. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Let it disappear now. Disappear now. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, challenges that will lead me to my greatness. Challenges that will lead me to my greatness. Look at me now in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray and talk to the Lord. Challenges that will lead me to my greatness. Look at me now. Look at me now. In Jesus' name we pray.